6 minutes to 6, said the great round clock over the information booth in Grand Central Station. The tall, young army lieutenant raised his face to note the exact time. His heart was pounding. In 6 minutes, he would see the woman who had filled such a special place in his life for the past 13 months. The woman he had never seen, yet whose written words had been with him and sustained him unfailingly. Lieutenant Blandford remembered one night in particular where he had seen the grinning face of one of the enemy pilots. In one of his letters, he had confessed to her.
Dear Hollis Minow, I often felt fear.
Dear Lieutenant Blandford, of course you fear. All brave men do. Didn't King David fear? That's why he wrote the 23rd Psalm. Next time you doubt yourself, I want you to hear my voice reciting to you. Yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me.
Lieutenant Blandford had heard her imagined voice, and it had renewed his strength and skill. Now he was going to hear her real voice. 4 minutes to 6. People were walking fast. A girl passed close to him, and Lieutenant Blandford started. She was wearing a red flower in her suit lapel, but it was a crimson sweet pea, not the little red rose they had agreed upon.
No, this girl is too young. Hollis Minow said she was 30. Well, I'm 32.
Actually, Lieutenant Blandford was 29. His mind went back to that book. Of all the hundreds of Army library books sent to the Florida training camp, he took the book of human bondage. He found himself intrigued, not with the words of the book, but with the notes penciled in the margin. The soft handwriting reflected a thoughtful soul, an insightful mind. He had never believed that a woman could see into a man's heart so tenderly, so understandingly. In front of the book, he discovered the previous owner's name, Miss Hollis Maynell. With time and effort, he located her address. She now lived in New York City. For 13 months, she had faithfully replied, and more than replied. When his letters did not arrive, she wrote anyway. And now he believed he loved her, and she loved him. Hollis Maynell had refused to send him her photograph. That seemed rather bad, of course, but she had explained.
If your feeling for me has any reality, any honest basis, what I look like won't matter. Suppose I'm beautiful. I've always been haunted by the feeling that you have been taking a chance on just that. And that kind of love would disgust me. Suppose I'm plain, then I've always feared that you were going and writing to me only because you were lonely and had no one else. No, don't ask for my picture. When you come to New York, you shall see me and then you shall make your decision. Remember, both of us are free to stop or to go on after that. Whichever we choose.
1 minute to 6. He pulled hard on his cigarette. Then Lieutenant Blandford's heart leaped higher than his plane had ever done. A young woman was coming toward him. In her pale green suit, she was like springtime come alive. He started toward her, entirely forgetting to notice that she was wearing no robes.
Going my way, soldier.
Uncontrollable, he made one step closer to her. Then he saw Hollis Maynell. She wore a red rose in the rumpled lapel of her brown coat. The girl in the green suit was walking quickly away. Blandford felt as though he were being split in two. So keen was his desire to follow the girl, yet so deep was his longing for the woman whose spirit had truly companioned and upheld his own. And there she stood. Her gray eyes had a warm, kindly twinkle. Lieutenant Blandford did not hesitate. His fingers gripped the book of human bondage, which was to identify him to her. He squared his broad shoulders, saluted, and held the book out toward the woman. Although even while he spoke, he felt choked by the bitterness of his disappointment.
I'm Lieutenant John Blandford, and you are Miss Maynell? I'm so glad you could meet me. May I take you to dinner?
I don't know what this is all about, son. That young lady in the green suit, the one who just went by, begged me to wear these robes in my coat. And she said that if you asked me to go out with you, I should tell you that she's waiting for you in that big restaurant across the street. She said it was some kind of test.
Let's go to the beach, each, let's go get a wave. They say what they gonna say, have a drink, clink, found a Bud Light. Bad bitches like me, it's hard to come by. The Patron, oh, let's go get it down. The sound, oh, yes, I'm in the zone. Is it two, three, leave a good tip. I'ma blow all of my money and don't give two shit.
I'm on the floor.